Mark, good to chat with you again. I'll start by feeling that has been brought from Saturday's result. How is the morale in this club right now?
Yeah, as you would imagine, very, very good. The players are in good hearts. A nice light session today, obviously, with the game tomorrow in mind. But no, the confidence that winning a game brings is always huge. So we want to obviously use that boost that we've had leading into the game and hopefully come out with on the back of the Hartlepool game with even more confidence, given that we're open for similar performance. We're always looking to improve, so if we can match or better what we produced at the weekend, then that'd be great. But no, they're all in good hearts, and we've got good numbers at the moment, a lot of players coming back from injury who will be a factor for us moving forward. So yeah, we're in good shape at the moment.
Where can you improve, if at all, from Saturday, if you've been particular?
I think, well, initially, I think probably we're a little bit cautious in our play in terms of, obviously, we want to play a little bit more when it's appropriate, and we were a little bit cautious initially, but I understand that, because we're from home against the league leaders. Clearly, first 10 minutes, don't concede, all those clichés, and I think they were in the back of the lads' mind. But once they got their foothold in the game, I thought we were more than composed enough in terms of what we were trying to do, played when we could, cleared our lines when we had to, and the performance was good. Towards the end, when obviously they were throwing bodies forward, we had to make sure we defended correctly with the right numbers, and we did that. And in the end, against a very good team, who have been the dominant team this year, we equipped ourselves really well, stopped their influential players really having a direct impact on the result, and that's credit to the boys.
We spoke about the significance of what that result can bring for the squad, but it also ended a few records in the sense of Andy's goal drought, which I think was his longest of the season. It was a clean sheet for the first time, I think it was 4 or 5 games. I mean, something like that, those components, they go a long way for a squad, don't they?
Oh yeah, you take those as positives, because that's what they are, clearly. And I spoke before, we're giving the guys new things to work with and maybe new ideas, but it's nothing that they're not capable of. There's no point trying to play in a way that would be too alien to the guys. They've got to be able to take on board the information and understand when to play and when not to play. And I think I said at the weekend, they're really coachable. They want to learn and they want to get better. And for me, that's great, because you can see that they're attentive, and when you tell them things, you sense that they're wanting to see if that will help them, and they're working hard in training to implement what we're talking about, and I see it in game time as well, which is the most important thing. It's no good talking about what we're going to do on the training field and then not transferring it to match days. So I've seen, obviously, I think many people have seen this transfer of what we work on the training pitch to the game of the weekends, and which is a good thing, and long may that continue.
Given the space between Saturday's game and Tuesday's game, is squad rotation a given for you in that circumstance?
Yeah, we'll do that on occasions, not necessarily tomorrow. I think obviously we've had a good result. We'll look at the squad. We've got a couple of concerns, but might resolve themselves, might not. But we've got good numbers now, and if players miss out, we can fill the void.
What are those concerns?
Well, probably the main one is Alex Gilliatt. He's just opened up his ankle joint, and he's probably been carrying it for a few weeks. He just got a bang on it just before the game, actually, in the warm-up, and it's a bit of concern, and if he is to miss out, well, so be it, but he should be okay for the weekend. It's not a long-term thing, but we'll just have to see how he is.
In a position to welcome anyone else back into the squad?
Well, the group is getting bigger. It's important that we do get those numbers. Obviously, the bigger the squad is, the more difficult it is for me in terms of picking guys, and unfortunately as a consequence of that, upsetting other players. So, but that's how it is, and Drouin have good options, and there are no options at all. Yeah. So we're in good shape in that regard.
Matty Daly was absent on Saturday. What was the reason behind that?
He's got a little bit of an injury. He's gone back to his club just to get it checked out. We'll wait and see on that, but that's why he wasn't available at the weekend.
And in terms of those in their rehabilitation, again, Charles Vernon, Tom Elliott, how are they progressing at the moment?
Very good. They joined in the whole session, both of them, today, which is the first time we've seen Tom out on the grass with the group. So, he had a good session. Well, they both did. And they're going to add to the squad, obviously. They're good players. Haven't been able to get them involved in match time, but they're very close to that now. They probably both need a week and a half, really, to get up to speed, given that they've been out for a little bit of time. But probably Tom could get back quicker because he's been out less time. But I'm excited by welcoming those two back, because just in the training session today, you can see the quality that they have. So that's going to add to the group. Almost certainly. So, we're in good shape in terms of injuries.
You were able to welcome back Jamie Walker on Saturday. Mm. What have you made to him in the time?
Jamie's a nice player. I like his work. He was a little bit of a shock to the system. He hadn't played for a while. Similar for Dion as well at the weekend. I think the first two or three runs they did maybe took them aback a little bit. But once they got their second wind, I thought they're both really good. They've got a little bit of quality. Obviously, they played at a good level, and the way sometimes when you see players, good quality players, they pass differently. The passes are cleaner with more pace and more appreciation, and Dean and Jamie both showed those qualities. So that's going to help. Obviously, the way we want to play, we want guys that are comfortable and calm in possession and are able to get the ball under control quickly, which they both can. So, I was pleased for them both at the weekend. They were part of a winning team, and they all played a part. Jamie obviously was instrumental in the latter game, getting obviously involved in a few parts of the game that were key. So, he'd be better for that. We want to give these guys game time if we can, because they're the quality that we need.
It gives you an opportunity as well to see them and know what they can do. And on Jamie specifically, I've had the chance to speak with him today, and his deal, of course, is out in the summer with his parent club. He's expressed the desire to stay at the club if the opportunity were to come about. You know, is that something that you're open to as well?
Well, yeah, I mean, those conversations are going to obviously... Well, they need to start sooner rather than later, because a lot of the guys get a little bit of anxiety, obviously, when they're out of contract. They want to get settled and know where they're going. So I'm aware of that. It's not something I'm blind to. So ideally, from my point of view, if we can get good quality and good numbers tied down quickly, and then maybe towards, as the summer progresses and we understand what's likely to be available, then we can add further. But guys that we think are going to be part of what we're doing, and they're in the building already, clearly you want them to be retained if we can.
I just want to ask you specifically on Andy Cook. When we spoke with him after the game on Saturday, he was quite open, actually, in the sense that he said he didn't know when that next goal was going to come. It was his longest drought of the season. I just wonder, as a fellow forward, you understand that feeling that he's had and almost sympathise in a way.
Yeah, absolutely. Andy does a lot of hard work that is probably not noticed by everybody, but at times it's a lonely role. But I think the way we're going to play and the way we want to play, he's not going to be as isolated maybe that he has been in the past. There's going to be people around him making good angles, good runs for him, and at times the build-up play won't involve him. He'll be able to just get it on the end of crosses in the box at the end of good play by an amount of the players in the team that are able to create for him. So I think he'll enjoy from now to the end of the season, I'm sure. Clearly, as a striker, and know what I was like when I didn't score. I was a little bit streaky. I wasn't one that scored every other game. When I did go on a run, I scored a reasonable amount, but then I would have times when I didn't score. So I think Andy's probably similar in that regard. So once you get off and run again, there's no reason why you can't go on a run and score a number of goals now, let's hope.
What does that come down to? Is that just an instinct or the way the game plays?
Well, sometimes you can try too hard. Sometimes you expend your energy in the wrong ways, and that takes away from where you need to really be dynamic and get on the end of things and use your strength and your energy and your experience to get on the end of things. Sometimes you can use it outside of the box when really you're more effective using that energy in the 6-yard box if you can, or certainly the 18-yard box. So I think it's because he's a genuine lad. He's given everything for the team, but sometimes as a striker like I was, you have to be a bit selfish and think, well, I'm just going to go with myself and see what happens. So sometimes that can open the floodgates.
Final one for me, and we've spoken a lot about how you've wanted to try and implement your style and the way that you want this side to play. And one notable thing I picked up on in the warm-up on Saturday was the drill, the shooting drill from outside the box. Is that something that you're encouraging the squad to do, not just the forwards but the midfielders as well, to strike from distance?
Well, yeah, we want to get good numbers at the top end of the pitch, and I think if we can play our way into good areas, then we're going to have numbers on the edge of the box anyway as a consequence of that. So if we get into the wide areas, good balls are coming into the box, things are going to drop in and around the edge as they did at the weekend. Yeah. So I think it's just a consequence of just getting up the pitch more and getting more bodies. Sometimes if you're back, from back to front too quickly, you can't get the numbers that you need where the ball is. So I think that will help us, obviously, if we can get shots off towards the top edge of the penalty area. Then, as you've seen, I've seen it a lot. There's a lot of games where there's a lot of bodies around and things ricochet and sometimes go for you, sometimes go against you. But if you don't buy a ticket, then you're never going to know. So, we encourage people to get forward and get shots off if they can.
Thank you, Mark.
Pleasure.
Hartlepool tomorrow night. What have you made
of them? Yeah, they look a good side. Just gone through, obviously, a little bit of analysis on them with the guys today, and just to give them a few pointers in terms of how they play. But they like to play a little bit from the back at times, and I think that's the way a lot of teams are going at the moment, which is fine. But as we know ourselves, it's about making sure that possession you get in deeper areas is with a purpose, and it's with the view of getting up the pitch quickly. It's not about just retaining possession. So, that's what we always talk about. I'm sure they do as well. So they look a good side. They've got good ability in key areas that we'll talk about again tomorrow. But like I said, there's a lot of good players at this level. That's not been a surprise. I expected it, but almost every team has got 2, 3, 4 guys that can possibly play at a higher level. So we have to acknowledge that and act accordingly.
As you said, the players have bought into what you want them to do, and presumably with that wind now behind them, that gives them even more confidence in the way it's to play.
Yeah, well, I think I mentioned it. Sometimes, like, I know myself and Glenn and all the coaching guys and the sports staff giving excellent information to the lads, but sometimes you need validation. Sometimes you need that first win to convince them that actually it is good information, it's information you can use. So thankfully, I'd like to think after the weekend, given how we played and what we tried to do in the game, that will help that process, and we'll start to really improve now.
Good luck.
So, have you noticed in the weeks you've been in it, sort of difference in the belief within the group? Because obviously it was quite a fragile group, probably mentally, with the way the season was going when you came in.
Well, yeah, I can only judge them on what I've found since I've been here, and it's more about just the enthusiasm they've seen, or I've seen from them, in terms of their work and their application. That's been first class. And so I've only judged them on that, and from my point of view, I've had no concerns whatsoever. Clearly, the season itself hasn't been what everybody wanted, and at times you'll see a little bit of, certainly in the early games, a lack of confidence to do the right thing at the right time. Only as much as that, sometimes it's a false economy just clearing your lines when a considered pass is the best option. But it's understandable if the season or games prior to the one you're playing in haven't gone as well. So, yeah, well, that's part of the process that we're going through at the moment, about changing the confidence and the level of understanding of what we're trying to do. That's going up daily. So, I'm pleased where we are at the moment. It's happened probably quicker than I thought, if I'm honest, because you're never quite sure what kind of group you've got to work with when you just walk through the door. But they've impressed me. I've already touched on a lot of teams at League Two level. I've got any number of players that can play at a high level, and we've certainly got players that can, or have done, and could still play at higher levels. So I've got good quality to work with, which I'm pleased with, and we'll try and get the best out of each and every one of them.
As you say, as that belief grows, presumably as they're learning more, it becomes hopefully more of a second nature to them when it matters.
Yeah, the best teams are the ones that do things automatically, and it's not without thought. It's just seeing a situation develop on the pitch and recognising it quickly, and you do what you need to do in that situation automatically and quickly, and that comes from repetition, seeing the same situation develop and reacting accordingly, and the more times you do it, the more automatic it becomes, not only for you as an individual, but the reaction of your teammates to what you do. And when we get to a point when everybody does it automatically, which is further down the road, I have to say, then we become a very good team. So there's still a little bit of work to be done before we get to that point, but that's the end game from our point of view.
And as you say, you've got that first win under the belt, which is great for everybody. This club hasn't actually managed two wins in a row since August.
Right, okay.
Which probably sums up how frustrating this season has been. So I know it's little milestones, but again, it's another sort of potential.
Yeah. Well, I'm glad you mentioned it. Yeah, I think I'll mention that tomorrow, actually, and use it in the pretty much pep talk. So, yeah, these things are things that niggle away at teams and just sap a little bit of confidence. So the more you can sweep away, the better.
As you say, and get that momentum towards the end of the season so players are enjoying themselves.
Yeah, well, I think the players are sick of me talking about momentum, but I seem to talk to them about it every single day. But it's a huge thing, and if you get it going and you can ride a wave of momentum, then it's surprising how far it can take you.